Hello guys, welcome back to Techzion. And today we are going to talk about the recently launched Poco F1, but not about the review, not about specification. This phone comes with a surprise, and if you want to know more, so stay tuned and let's get started. So Xiaomi has recently launched the Poco F1, which is called the Master of Speed by Xiaomi in India. But do you know what? That phone comes with a surprise, comes with a catch. Now, that thing is, the Xiaomi Poco F1 does not support, or you can say block, HD content streaming on Netflix and Amazon Prime. Yeah, you heard it right. It is not allowing to access the HD content on the Netflix as well as the Prime membership of Amazon. Now, why this thing occurs? This is not a software issue, right? So the Xiaomi Poco F1 lacks the widevine support. Now what's widevine? Poco F1 comes with widevine DRM level 3 as compared to the level 1, which is usually required to stream HD content over Amazon Prime as well as the Netflix. Now DRM stands for your digital rights management feature that is able to decrypt the encrypted file. Okay, so it's an standard, popularly available standard, you can say, that is available. It's available free of cost, right? Now, if a user attempt to watch content, that is through these two applications, Netflix or Amazon Prime, HD content will only be played out on a device that supports widevine. And you might be surprised that the other phones of Xiaomi as well, like the Xiaomi Mi A2, as well as the other different phones, Redmi Note 5 Pro, which were launched in the Max Pro, also does not support these features. Now the company does not want to get into the hassles of, you know, going through it. That is why the support is absent here. So the problem, I am reiterating it, it is not a software issue and it cannot be fixed through a security patch or a software upgrade. Now the question arises, why widevine? Or why DRM? Now most of the sites like the Netflix and the stream and other streaming sites, they rely on digital rights management, as I have told you earlier, and it is one of the oldest DRM standard that we have, right? It encompasses three levels, that are level 1, level 2 and level 3, right? For Amazon Prime and Netflix, you need to get to the level 1. So widevine, what it uses is a combination of CNC encryption. Along with it, it has an adaptive streaming quality and licensing key exchange. Now why these three things are needed? In order to prevent the content from being pirated, you know, that is the major requirement. So all to implement this, the device has to be within a trusted execution environment of the processor. And you might be wondering what TEE is. Now Trusted Execution Environment is nothing but all Cortex-A based chips have this. This is created in the name of Trust Zone, right? So it kind of creates a hardware separation, okay? Allowing the Android to create the TEE for the DRM. Now, when the device like Xiaomi or other devices does not have this, in spite of no license fee, being charged by the Google to implement it, I think they didn't want to include this because they need to pass certification process for it, which include multiple level agreements, software libraries and testing and verification to support it. And we might think that if these phones are budget phones, right, so below 20k category, all these phones, right? And to correct you, Asus Zenfone Max Pro does support it, right? And it support widevine L1 certificate, right, along with Asus Zenfone 5c, right? So let's see how Xiaomi, you know, can include this in their future smartphone, because previously this thing also happened in OnePlus 5T as well as OnePlus 5, and they needed to recall each and every phone because this thing cannot be updated or fixed through an OTA update. So this is it for now. Video. So stay tuned and thank you for watching my video. So if you like the video, do share, subscribe and hit the like button.